I would like to discuss with you some clinical cases to apply our basic information on and mean making this information meaningful and also clinically relevant. So let us look at the first case in which we discuss lesion in the spinal cord. So the first case is talking about a 42-year-old woman who had car accident and fracture her spine in the lower back region. I want from you to pay attention to this region that it we point to lower back region. Okay, it means like lumbar area. Neurological examination revealed the following abnormalities. First, paralysis in the left leg. What kind of paralysis? You can guess by looking at deep tendon reflex. There is increased reflexes or hyperreflexia, and also Babinski sign on the left side was positive, and suggested you that this paralysis is upper motor neuron paralysis. And it is located in the left leg. Loss of proprioception vibration and the discriminative touch sensation of the entire left leg. Again, we are talking about left leg. What do we have here now? There is loss of deep sensation. Ask yourself this question: which tract carrying this sensation? And how it go from the periphery until it reach to the brain, where it cross. So this information help you to reach to the diagnosis. Complete anesthesia in a specific area over the hip and the front of the thigh. And this area most probably lumbar 1 and lumbar 2. And again, this is very specific area or dermatomes. Lastly, there is loss of pain and temperature sensation in the right leg and the buttock. So this is the only sensation which lost in left in the right leg. The other sensation was left leg. So now we have loss of pain, temperature in the right, and we have loss of deep sensation in the left leg. Okay, so what do you think is the answer here? This is hemisection in the right side. So the spinal cord in the right side has totally injured, including posterior column, lateral column, anterior column, dorsal horn and ventral horn. Then we have here in the answer number B, we have the anterior two-third of the spinal cord. The anterior two-third of the spinal cord means that we are looking at something like anterior spinal artery occlusion, anterior spinal artery occlusion. Okay, and also this is including only lateral column and anterior column, plus the anterior horn. So number C, you have left side. The left side is affected, is hemisection again in the left side. Okay, looking at this information, left leg, we have lost the deep sensation. We have upper motor neuron paralysis. Okay, so the answer which makes sense is going to be C. Why C? Because posterior column has gracile and deconiate tract which receive pain, sorry, which receive deep sensation, touch and proprioception from the same side, coming from the same side, then ascend until it reaches to the medulla, then cross to the opposite side. And, okay? So it's coming from here, then ascend in the spinal cord in the same side, then cross to the opposite side, but in medulla. So if the injury at the level of spinal cord, the loss of sensation going to be in the same side. Okay, so we are talking about lumbar region. It means that the gracile tract is the one which being affected because gracile carrying sensation from lower extremity, however, conate carrying sensation from upper extremity. Second, in the lateral column you have corticospinal tract. The corticospinal tract, which is this upper motor neuron. Again, the corticospinal tract is coming from where? It's coming from right side, right cerebral cortex, then descend, and the medulla cross to the opposite side, then going to the opposite side of spinal cord. But from spinal cord, it's going to supply muscles in the same side. Again, this is upper motor neuron paralysis because of corticospinal tract in the lateral column. Then coming to pain and the temperature. If you come here, the pain and temperature, we lost the pain and temperature where? Pain and temperature in the right side. Why in the right side, not left side? Because you will find the anterolateral system here, you will find the lateral spinothalamic tract located in this area, in the lateral column, receiving actually pain and temperature from the opposite side. If you remember, coming from the skin, pain and temperature ascend in the spinal cord for one or two segments, for couple segments, before crossing to the opposite side. And here forming the spinothalamic tract, the spinothalamic tract, the lateral spinothalamic tract, which ascend finally to the thalamus in the same side. Okay, so that's why pain and temperature lost in the right side, in the right leg, not left leg. Okay, so let us go and look here at what we see. So this is the lesion is again hemisection in the left side, which you call it Braun-Schwartz syndrome. Braun-Schwartz syndrome. The Braun-Schwartz syndrome, again, which including one side of the spinal cord extending from dorsal column to the ventral column, cutting spinothalamic tract, this red color, the spinothalamic tract or anterolateral system, which is responsible for pain sensation, and also this one touch, and coming from the opposite side. It's coming from the opposite side. Okay? And you have corticospinal tract, this one, the corticospinal tract responsible for supplying muscles in the same side. That's why there is upper motor neuron paralysis in the same side. Finally, you have the gracile tract, the blue color tract here. This is gracile tract which receive touch sensation from the same side. Where it cross? It cross in medulla up to the other side. That's why lesion, to have lesion such as upper motor neuron paralysis in the left side, you either have injury in the spinal cord in the same side or injury in the brain in the opposite side. So if the injury here in the right cerebral hemisphere, in the motor area of the right cerebral hemisphere, is going to lead to similar paralysis as left spinal cord because of the corticospinal tract. I hope that this is clear. We're still looking here at the yellow tract. The yellow tract are spinocerebellar tract. You have ventral, you have dorsal. This spinocerebellar tract carrying proprioception to unconscious level, which is cerebellum. That's why we call it spinocerebellar tract. Coming from, again, the carrying proprioception and sense of position going to cerebellum. Usually again to the same side, it end up, that's why injury of cerebellum leads to ipsilateral deformity or dysfunction. However, injury in the cerebrum leads to contralateral problem. So why we don't see ataxia in this patient? Because there is paralysis. Ataxia is gait, disturbed gait and disturbed balance, and also loss of muscle coordination, all this because if we have paralysis, so you don't see ataxia. But ataxia should be there, but it is masked by paralysis. So here is the summary. The lateral corticospinal tract leads to ipsilateral upper motor neuron paralysis, which is characterized by hyperreflexia and the positive Babinski sign. Then the gracile tract, which is affected, leads to loss of proprioception and the vibration in the dermatomes below the lesion. Okay, below the lesion, but in the same side, ipsilateral. Lateral spinothalamic tract, as I mentioned, which is red color, this is bringing pain and temperature from the right leg. So that's why loss of sensation in the right leg. Then we have injury also, since we are talking about hemisection. And hemisection does not include white matter only or columns, but also dorsal and ventral horn. That's why we will have dermatomal effect, where dorsal horn, this area, let us say that this is lumbar 1, lumbar 2 area, so you will see ipsilateral loss of pain and temperature, but at this specific dermatomes, which mentioned in the case scenario over hip and thigh, the upper part of the thigh. So basically lumbar 1 and lumbar 2 mostly. So that's why it is ipsilateral. If we have ipsilateral loss of pain and temperature, it's going to be very limited because of this dorsal horn. But below the level is going to be in the right side. Similar, this segment of spinal cord, which is the ventral horn here, supplies specific muscles, like a specific myotomes, we call it myotome. So basically also there will be lower motor neuron paralysis in few muscles, which is supplied by the injured segment. So if I ask you, does this case of hemisection include upper and lower motor neuron paralysis? The answer, yes. The upper motor neuron paralysis due to injury of the corticospinal tract. The lower motor neuron paralysis is going to be due to the injury of the ventral horn. Second question, where is the paralysis which is upper motor neuron, and where is the paralysis of lower motor neuron? Both of them are going to be in the same side, which is left side. However, the lower motor neuron will be limited to few muscles supplied by the same segment of spinal cord which is damaged. However, the corticospinal tract again is going to be like below the level, yeah, affecting all muscles below the level because you cut the descending tract. Similar, does this hemisection include loss of pain and temperature in both sides? The quick answer, yes, both sides, but the widespread loss of pain temperature is going to be on the opposite side, because the opposite side here ascending going to opposite side here forming the spinothalamic tract. However, because of the injury of this dorsal horn, the dorsal horn again received from limited area in the same side. Okay, so what is the differential diagnosis? Differential diagnosis, one of them is anterior spinal artery occlusion. Anterior spinal artery occlusion, if you remember, the anterior spinal artery supplying is going to supply the anterior two-thirds of the spinal cord. When I say the anterior two-thirds of the spinal cord, it means lateral column, ventral column, and ventral horn. What does this mean? It's going to be affect corticospinal tract on both sides, so it's going to be bilateral upper motor neuron paralysis. And then you have spinothalamic tract on both sides, the red color tract, so it's going to be bilateral loss of pain and temperature. Then the spinothalamic tract, so the spinocerebellar tracts again on both sides, this is disturbing the subconscious proprioception, but as I mentioned, because we have paralysis, the ataxia will not be noticed. Okay, so then we have again like complete motor paralysis below the level of the lesion, complete below the level of the lesion due to interruption of the corticospinal tract. It can be paraplegia or quadriplegia, depend on the level of the injury. If the injury at the cervical region and above, is going to be paraplegia, quadriplegia. So the four limbs are going to be paralyzed. If it is an injury in thoracolumbar region, so it's going to be paraplegia. Then we have loose pain and temperature sensation at and below the level of the lesion. One more thing, you need to the difference between here and the other side, first of all, this is affecting the muscles in both sides, affecting pain and temperature in both sides versus hemisection, and also sparing the gracile and the conate. Gracile and the conate are not affected. They are healthy. So basically, the proprioception is intact, sense of position is intact. Okay? Okay, I hope that this is clear, and we'll continue looking at different scenarios. Thank you.